Hey guys, in this video I will share 4 pandas functions that I wish I knew earlier. To demonstrate the functions, I will use the tips dataset from the Seaborn library. This example dataset contains information about the total bill, the tip size, additional information about the customer, and the day and time of the customer's visit. Let's kick things off with one of my favorite pandas functions. Whenever I'm dealing with data, more often than not I need to filter the dataset. A straightforward way is by using the pandas query function. In this example, I only want to get the male customer, where the size column is greater than 2. Before knowing the query function, I was using a Boolean mask with my filter expression. Yet, that method tends to get pretty messy, especially if you include more criteria. What makes the query function so neat is that you can also include variables. Let's say you want to return only the data for Saturday and Sunday. In the first step, I have created a list with my filter criteria. By using the @ symbol, I can now pass the variables into the query function. So the next time you filter your dataset, you might want to give this pandas function a try. Okay, let us move on to the second tip. Let's say you want to return the 5 largest bill amounts. In that case, you can use nLargest. Before knowing this function, I always sorted the values in descending order and then returned the head. Yet, this function makes it much easier. Likewise, you can also return the smallest values by using nSmallest. My next tip is the groupBy function. And you might know this function already, but it took me some time to realize that you can also pass additional parameters to this function. Let's start with a simple example by grouping the dataset based on the gender information and returning the mean for all numerical values. By the way, this is very similar to a pivot table in Excel. You could, of course, also group it by multiple columns. Now, what makes it so powerful is that you can combine groupBy with the aggregation function. Let's say, on top of the mean, you would also like to return the sum of all numerical values. In that case, you can write it as follows. Additionally, you could use various aggregation methods for different columns. To demonstrate this, I have created a simple dictionary. For this example, I would like to return the sum of the total bill column, and for the tips, pandas should calculate the mean. As a next step, I'm passing this dictionary to the aggregation function. As a result, pandas will return this data frame. In many cases, I don't want to have multiple indexes. To flatten the data frame, you can set sIndex to false. After executing this line, the data frame looks like this. Okay, and the last tip I have for you is the pandas cut function. With the pandas cut function, you can create different bins or categories for a specific column. Let me demonstrate this by an example. If we look at the distribution of the tip amount, we can see that most customers give a tip between $2 and $3. Now I want to insert a new column and categorize the tips based on the amount. So let's say from $0 to $2, it should fall into the small category. Everything above $2 and up to $4 should belong to the medium bracket. Tips higher than $4 and up to $11 should be labeled as high. After defining the bins and labels, I can pass those lists to the pandas cut function. As a result, pandas will create a new column with the different categories. In many cases, I don't want to use a hard-coded number as my upper limit. For example, if a customer feels very generous and gives a tip of $20, it should also fall into the high category. You could, of course, enter a high number here, like 10,000, but a more elegant solution is to use float infinity for the upper bound limit. Respectively, for the lower bound, you could type float minus infinity. Okay guys, and those are my 4 pandas functions that I wish I knew earlier. Let me know which function was new for you, or even better, share your favorite pandas trick in the comments. As always, thanks for watching and see you next time!